We've got basketball action at the AT&T Center. We're in San Antonio, Texas, the home of the Spurs, live on 2K Sports. This is Kevin Harlan with Greg Anthony and Doris Burke. Also joining us from the sidelines, David Aldridge. Looking at Toronto, they took the win in their last game against the Jazz.
And I was impressed with how comfortable they looked in that environment, made the most of their possessions.
They were extremely efficient, Greg. They ran their offense well and took good high percentage shots.
Well, we're around the halfway point now, Doris. Some clubs are obviously in a rebuild mode, but it can be hard for many team owners to accept that and accept that path they're on.
Well, when you've been the guy to make that financial investment, there can be a little bit of impatience because one of your responsibilities is keep people in the seats. You've got to pay the bills. What you have to do is you make clear to the fans the vision that they have. If you make it clear, Kev, maybe they can sort of embrace the rebuild and celebrate the step-by-step progress.
Here are the five for the Raptors. Kyle Lowry and Danny Green are the guard tandem. And it's Ibaka. Then there's Kawhi Leonard. And it's Siakam in at the four.
Now that's how you pick up second chance points. Stay active and be ready as soon as the shot goes up.
All right, now let's find out what head coach Nick Nurse had to say to David Aldridge. David.
Well, Kevin, they have a specific approach to tonight's game. He told me they have to get the ball into the paint as much as possible and take advantage of what they believe is a big inch for them inside. We'll see if they're right about that tonight. Back to you.
Thank you, David. For Toronto, they've gone 2-3 here to start off the game. Outside Lowry. And it's Leonard at the elbow. The putback, great positioning on the putback.
Kev, we know this about Serge Ibaka. This guy is a strong presence on the offensive glass. If you don't check him out, you're going to get hurt.
And Forbes kicks to Gay. 14 feet away. Misses off the left iron.
Superb defense, guys. No way he's going to let him get off a clean look at the basket.
And that one's good, Leonard.
And their offense already in a flow. Some stellar shooting to jump out to this lead. And with Kawhi Leonard, he just does everything well on the floor. Offense, defense, rebounding, runs the floor. I mean, he is one of the more complete players in our league. He can completely take over a game on both ends.
Here's Lowry following the three-pointer by San Antonio. Ibaka, the pass to Leonard. Over Gay. And it hung on the rim, but wouldn't fall for him. And a little over 2.5 minutes gone here in the first. Here is Forbes, while recovering. Cunningham kicks to DeRozan. Down to 5 on the shot clock. Over Green. From 13 feet, it goes down. DeRozan's got his first bucket of the night.
Well, we know this about DeMar DeRozan. The mid-range has always been a special part of his game. And, boy, you do not want to let him start to cook from there.
Now, here's Lowry. He's certainly been a consistent piece of their offense, averaging about 14.5 points a game. Pass to Siakam. That's good, and it's Leonard with the assist. Siakam's got 5 points so far.
And defensively, this is a nightmare. He's already on a roll.
Greg, the defense better start to disrupt his rhythm, or it's going to be an awfully long night for them.
Here's Aldridge. Rebound by the Raptors. And this matchup with the Spurs, it's their first meeting of the season.
And really, this is a team that expects to beat everyone when they step on the floor, but they were only able to split the series last year.
You wonder if they're looking to take control of this one early. And when you have more talent, you want to keep the other guys from gaining any confidence.
At the elbow, Green. Bounce pass from Lowry. Here's Leonard, and he gets contact and the whistle on the shot. Two shots coming up. And the foul goes against San Antonio.
When he was in high school in California, Kawhi won the state's Mr. Basketball Award. And you look at the list of guys who've won that award over the years, it has a lot of the all-time greats on it.
And And the first one drops. Free throws good from Kawhi Leonard.
Boy, he's just been so consistent, right? I mean, every time he's gotten to the stripe, he's delivered. This is great stuff.
And that concludes the first quarter of play. It's the Raptors leading by 9. And the second quarter will get underway just after this short break. Now, a veteran in the NBA, Serge Ibaka, talked about his role on this team.
I like to do all those little things, running up and down, blocking shot, straight to floor, making open shot, you know, roaring the basket, screen, you know, those dirty work. I like to do that.
And Ibaka, Greg, a great complimentary player.
And you like his combination of size and skill, able to impact the game at both ends on a high level.
And so far through one quarter, it's been a lopsided game. We'll see if that changes here in the second. And guys, what's your take on Toronto so far?
Tough defense throughout that first period, and it's really paying dividends.
Well, I think there's a level of physicality with them right now, and not allowing the opponent to feel comfortable getting into their heads just a bit.
They've got Poeltl. White is out there with Mills. Then there's Bellinelli, and it's Bertans in at the four. That's the San Antonio five. And Marco Bellinelli, a player who has always been able to light it up from outside.
And Belly has been on so many teams in his career, but is always a wanted commodity due to his shooting. Very quick and easy way to add outside shooting to a team. He can honestly play a long time just on how badly teams need shooting in our league.
Here's Mills. The Raptors getting the bucket. To the inside, White. And it's right, sending it back.
And a moment now to look at the numbers for Siakam. Averaging 15 points a game, 6 rebounds, and 2 assists.
Two shots, gentlemen.
And he gives them a nice rotation on the front court. He is a quality reserve.
Well, the one thing you can't teach is size. He's not as developed skill-wise as some guys, but certainly a valuable backup for this team.
Shooting 2.
And that one falls for White. And Doris, to try and improve the flow of the games, teams now have fewer timeouts. Players have to be faster about retaking the court after stoppages. I'm assuming you're like me, all good things, right?
I agree, Kevin, and I think what people don't know is the impetus from this actually came from the coaches themselves. Rick Carlisle said, listen, we need to pick up the pace of play because we'd like our games to fit in a certain time frame. And listen, when you've got the leadership at the top in Adam Silver, who always makes clear that game flow is one of his focuses and that this is an entertainment medium and let's please our fans, you're going to make the right choices.
Passes it to Anunoby. Mills with the steal.
Not a problem. First turnover of the game, but overall, I like how they're taking care of the basketball.
Three-pointer. Siakam pulls it in. Raptors leading by 5. Here's Anunoby, and 2 free throws coming up. Unable to get that one to go with all the content.
OG Anunoby is tremendously athletic, and when he plays with this level of aggression, it's hard not to foul him. You know what you love about watching OG Anunoby? You feel like you're watching a vet when you watch this guy. He doesn't seem to get rattled in pressure situations. This guy plays like he's been in the league for a decade.
Free throw, no good. And Doris, for Anunoby, he has said he felt like he could compete with anyone.
Well, to me, Kevin, that's part of being able to be the defender he is. He's got strength and quickness to match up with most wings in the league, but confidence is critical.
San Antonio making a switch here. Gasol's checked in. second free throw, no good.
And the potential Anunoby has is exciting. Has the athleticism, the shooting touch, and the drive to keep improving.
Now here's Mills. An 11-point game for him in the win against Boston. Six to shoot. Pulls up on the wing. The shot by Bellinelli. No good. Raptors leading by five. A wide open look here for Wright. And the shot goes in from Siakam. Siakam's got 7 points.
Just reliable, guys. He's just always trying to make the right play.
And let's catch up with our sideline reporter, David Aldridge.
Well, guys, Kyle Lowry is a player who has worked his way to stardom. He says, I still feel like I can be better. I'm never satisfied. My team is good, but I think the best I can be is a champion. There is no other goal in basketball. Guys?
D.A., that's how you truly create a legacy. Toronto with the ball after the basket by San Antonio. 107 left in the second quarter. Here's Van Vliet. 8 points his last outing. Pulls up. High post. Gasol with the rebound. Wright against White. Pass to Mills. Outside Gasol. Bertans kicks to White. Over Wright. Off target from the wing. Raptors leading by five, fires from 18. He gets it in there. And just over 3.5 minutes played here in the second quarter. Guys, they're looking for a spark here.
Yeah, a cold stretch offensively, for sure.
Mills with it. He's still scoreless so far in this one. Just 4 to shoot. Gasol hits the close-range jumper.
And what about the graceful release of Gasol? No one can touch him when he's in rhythm.
And that'll do it for the first half, a competitive game so far. Raptors lead by 5. It's time now to go courtside as we send you over to David Aldridge from the sideline. David, take it away.
Thank you, Kevin. Here with Greg Popovich. Pop, what do you think was the main issue during the first half?
We didn't make shots.
Thank you for that insightful analysis, Coach. Back to you, Kevin.
All right, David, thank you, and stay with us, folks. We'll be back just after halftime to get the third quarter started.
And now, the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hello! You're watching the NBA Halftime Show on 2K Sports. Ernie Johnson. Here at this beautiful table. This is a beautiful, beautiful table.
What is this, oak?
I think it's teak.
Oh, teak.
There's Shaq. There's Kenny.
It's polished oak.
Teak. It's polished very nice. Teak. It's very nice.
You mean antique?
No, it's just teak.
Teak.
I have an ante.
It's Toronto with the advantage at the half. They lead by 5. Kenny?
Well, I think to shoot a high percentage, your offense has to be in sync. And in the first half, those guys were sharing the basketball, playing for each other. Now it becomes a matter of being consistent at it.
Shaq, let's get your thoughts on San Antonio.
Well, you want to try to hold your opponent under 50% shooting. That has not happened. Defensively, they're allowing way too many good looks. They need to do a better job of shutting down the lane, as well as closing out on shooters.
And that'll do it for our halftime report. Stay tuned for the second half, about to get underway.
A spectacular aerial shot of downtown San Antonio, Texas, the Tower Life Building, front and center. We welcome you back. And as we get into this third quarter, as we've seen so far, neither team able to create much separation on the scoreboard yet. You have to like what we're seeing so far from Kawhi Leonard.
Yeah, and night after night, man, it just becomes common to watch him rip through teams, and that's exactly what we saw there in the first half.
You know, Greg, I think the thing you admire is the incredible level of consistency. This guy is a fantastic player, but he also puts in a ton of energy. absolutely tremendous.
And after a fairly even first couple of quarters, the second half could turn out to be a great one as both teams try to gain an edge. And on the floor for Nick Nurse as we get into the second half. Kyle Lowry and Danny Green are the guards handling. Then there's Kawhi Leonard. Then it's Ibaka. And it's Siakam in at the four. And the shot is good. The Raptor lead has been cut down now to just three on the bucket from Aldridge. Toronto shooting 53% from the floor. They're locked in. And the Spurs now in the post-Kawhi Leonard era of the franchise. Greg, how do they recover, do you think?
If any team can survive losing a player of Kawhi's caliber, it's got to be the Spurs. They have good depth, got a good return in the trade, and players will step up. Won't be the power they once were for a while, but they'll rebound in no time.
So it's the Spurs now. Raptors knocking down the tray. And he'll shoot free throws here. Clearly fouled on that shot that time. The whistle blowing.
And you know what? You allow a guy to get right to the rim like that, that's your only option.
San Antonio shooting their third and fourth free throw shots of the night.
And they've had really good numbers all season from the free throw line.
And the first one drops. Doris, look in your crystal ball. 5 years from now, who do you think will be the two, three best players in the NBA?
Well, certainly some of the names. I won't say this is a definitive list, but as long as health holds, I'm going to give you three men who are going to be bad men in the NBA for a long time. Giannis Antetokounmpo, because the Greek freak is able at his size to handle it, take it off the window, and dominate action in transition. If he gets a consistent jump shot, forget about it. Ben Simmons, exactly the same thing. His passing ability is extraordinary. I think you'll see him get a low post game, and I think he'll get a jump shot, and he will be unguardable. And one of my absolute favorites is Mr. Joel Embiid. Give it to you inside, give it to you outside. Mr. Embiid can handle it. He can dominate with his defense. Those three men are going to be all-stars for a long, long time.
And the Spurs with possession. Kawhi Leonard unable to get his shot to go. Third quarter of play with just over a minute and a half gone by. Green finds Lowry. No good on the triple. And so it's Cunningham. He'll bring it up for San Antonio. Since the second half started, they've only given up 3 points. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot two at the free throw line. It's on Kawhi Leonard. And Rudy Gay, Greg, has always been a fantastic scorer since he came into the NBA.
And Gay doesn't do as much scoring as he once did, but he has become more efficient. Doesn't have plays ran for him, gets looks through his instinct. And as he's gotten older, Gay has become even more crafty with how he scores.
And he knocks down the first one.
And when Gay is locked in, he's special. An efficient scorer who can effortlessly take over games.
Pirtle, he's checked in for Dante Cunningham. That one drops. He ties it up. Here is Lowry. He's gotten some minutes, but nothing on the board yet. 2 minutes gone in this third quarter now. On the wing, Leonard, no luck.
And why take that contested shot? I mean, make the extra pass.
No, that's a head scratcher. When the defense is in your grill, move the ball.
Green inside the 3-point line, hits the front of the rim and out. Down low, and Aldridge slams it in.
And that's a case where DeMar DeRozan's teammates benefiting from him being a willing distributor. This is a very team-first guy.
Now, here's Lowry. And on our sideline, our reporter, David Aldridge.
Well, guys, we see new players coming into prominence for the San Antonio Spurs. Now, Greg Popovich gives his veterans credit for accepting it gracefully and helping the young guys be successful. He says it's a tribute to their character and awareness. Kevin?
They certainly have established a great culture in San Antonio. Really something. DA, thank you. Aldridge with it. It's Ibaka picking him up. Five on the clock. Inside. And that's dunked by Aldridge.
And when Pirtle sees one of his guys wide open, he whips it his way. He's all for doing what's best for the team.
Now here is Lowry. Nothing yet on the scoreboard for him. Leonard against Gay. Leonard inside. And it's good with time running down on the shot clock. Leonard's got the game tied up here for Toronto. Here is Forbes, now recovering. Here is Forbes. He averages more than 12 points a game. That's some dependable production. Can't hit from 12.
Well, the defense trying to get out on him, but he's left with the open shot. He's got to make that one.
Tie game in San Antonio. We're going to step aside for just a second, but join us right back here for the start of the fourth quarter next. And a moment now as we take a look at our State Farm assists of the game.
And definitely deserving of the prize tonight. How about the read he made here? Looking like a point guard, putting the pass right on the money.
Now, Greg, he's got the size to survey over the top of the defense and find the open man. That was beautiful.
And with three quarters behind us, we start the fourth quarter in what is still anybody's ballgame. Toronto's gone 3 of 5 from beyond the arc so far tonight. DeRozan and Gay, the wings. Then it's Mills. Then there's Poeltl. And it's Bertāns in at the four spot. That's the San Antonio five. Here's Van Vliet. Shot clock at 6. Ananobi. Sweet little floater. Ananobi's got the first field goal of the fourth quarter here for the Raptors.
I'll tell you, it's 6'8" with elite athleticism. Good luck checking OG Ananobi on the interior.
The pass to Mills. Lets it go with a 3. Drains it from beyond the arc. And the Spurs lead by 1.
The defenders need to recognize the importance of staying on him as we get into crunch time.
Van Vliet passes to Leonard. Goes up on the wing. And another basket for Toronto.
And he has the chops for this, raising the intensity when it matters most.
Right, you love the aggressiveness. This guy is willing to take over at the key opportunities.
Now here's DeRozan. Back to Poeltl. Gay scanning before. Shoots over Leonard. Gay can't hit. Toronto's shooting has been terrific. 54% on the game. And it's Leonard missing. So it's the Spurs now. It's a 1-point game. Here's DeRozan. Good.
Well, the handles of DeMar DeRozan taking center stage there. How about the ball skills? Taking advantage of those and converting.
Here's Van Vliet. Game moves along. 2 minutes gone here in the fourth. Leonard dishes to right. Shoots over DeRozan, and that one's good. Right, game winding down, and they just keep changing leads.
And guys, no separation yet, and I really don't think we're going to see any all the way down.
Time called here. The Spurs decide to talk it over. They're down by 1. 1:49 left in the fourth quarter. And with this game closing in on the final buzzer, let's take a look at our Jordan player of the game.
And his percentage from the field tonight seemed almost made up. I didn't think it was possible to have that kind of success shooting the basketball. You need a little bit of luck, a bunch of hard work, and a whole lot of talent.
And on our sideline, our reporter, David Aldridge.
Well, guys, during the last break, I listened to Greg Popovich talk to his team. Three-pointers have hurt them tonight, and told his players, we've got to play them better on the three-point line. We can't give them any more clean looks. Kevin?
Here's DeRozan. After Toronto picking up the basket just moments ago. The shot's good from Forbes.
Well, I think this is a great area of growth for DeMar DeRozan, his ability to use his teammates to enhance the team scoring.
Yep, that one goes.
And really, the defense on both sides, non-existent.
Yeah, as strong as some of these offensive performances have been, it's just not been solid on the defensive end. Neither team showing much heart in that department.
Two free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul.
Oh, the officials are all over that one.
It's the first, and that brings them within two here. Both free throws good from Aldridge.
Well, you knew he was going to come through there. The more that's riding on it, the better he seems to be.
Van Vliet pitch to Leonard. Pulls it from the elbow. Count it!
And he's just putting the team on his back when he's needed most.
Don't you just love to see that confidence when taking these big shots?
Pass to DeRozan. Over Green. It's good! And what a sensational bucket to bring them within one.
And this is why they want the ball in DeRozan's hand. This guy is stone cold under pressure.
And there is a whistle. That goes on Bryn Forbes. That is his first foul of the game.
What's up?
He throw good, Ibaka.
And that point was a gift. I mean, it's never really smart to get teed up, but in a game that's this close, boy, that really hurts.
There's 42 seconds left in the game. Here's Leonard. Tries again. Sinks it.
Oh, Kev, how about the experience that Ibaka brings? He's able to be comfortable in any situation.
The 11-footer. Here's Aldridge. Another shot. Siakam pulls it in. And so they foul intentionally.
Honestly, just doing what they have to in order to get the basketball back.
Shooting two.
So the first one drops, and that puts them up by five. So he goes two for two at the line, and it's a six-point ball game.
Boy, very productive trip to the line that time, and they're sitting on a nice lead now.
Time called here. The Spurs decide to talk it over. They're trailing by six. 19 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Green against DeRozan. San Antonio again missing, and he commits the intentional foul.
No choice but to foul there, but he's probably the last guy you want to see on the line.
Take a break. Two shots.
Britt on the first, and that makes it a seven-point lead. And so he drops them both. It's an 8-point game. And White kicks to Cunningham. Gasol passes to White. Again, the miss by the Spurs. And so it's Toronto winning this one. They came in here and took care of business like they were the home team.
And Kevin, how about the mental toughness that this group showed? They were never rattled at all by the opposing fans.
And now let's catch up with David Aldridge, who's standing by from the sideline. All right, Dave.
Thanks, Kevin. Serge, big win tonight. Now, people may think you have some easy games on the schedule, but you did not play easy tonight.
Because we know where we want to go, you know. That's why he was focused tonight. We got to finish strong.
And it was a strong performance, Serge. Thanks for your time. Back to you, Kevin.
All right, David, thank you. And that's going to do it tonight, folks, for our broadcast. For Greg Anthony, Doris Burke, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan along with our terrific 2K Sports crew, thanking you for tuning in. We'll see you next time.